There's seven things that make us old. I call them the seven pillars.
Okay.
We're actually at the point where we know these seven things will do it. One of them is mitochondrial mutations or essentially insufficiency. I wanted to make enough energy to repair a cell. I couldn't make enough energy with the food you gave me or with the state of the cell. So I didn't repair the cell. Mm. And then bad things happen.
And then you get old.
Yeah. And so if that's one, the next one is something that I call cellular straitjackets. Everyone's heard of beta amyloid plaque because, oh, we have Alzheimer's disease, everyone has amyloid. But what you don't know is amyloid forms throughout your body in all of your proteins because it's almost like a cellular level scar tissue. Imagine each cell, every time it gets inflamed, it just wants to get a little bit more scar tissue. This is happening. If you're gonna live to at least 180 like I am, you might want it to happen a little bit less. Otherwise, I'm gonna be walking around pretty stiff when I'm old. That one, it turns out what you eat really matters, because if you eat stuff that makes you inflamed, that constant chronic low levels of inflammation, that's what does that.
That builds up, yeah.
Yeah, so you're talking 20, 30 years after this stuff starts, and all of a sudden just bad stuff is going on in your body, you don't know why, and literally the cells can't move the way they're supposed to move. Mm-hmm. Then there's zombie cells. Cells that should die, but don't. And they sit there and they take up space and resources. They make free radicals, but they don't do their job anymore. Turns out fasting causes autophagy, which is one of the ways to do it. Our cells have these things called lysosomes, and their job is to take broken down parts of the cell or parts of food metabolism and digest them and use them. So it's sort of like a furnace that burns waste, it burns garbage. So if you went to the dump, there's an incinerator. But what if you put stuff in the incinerator that wouldn't burn? Eventually it gets full and you can't use the incinerator because there's no more space to put stuff in. Well, that's happening in your cells right now. So what you do is you put in less stuff in your body that your cells can't break down. So in other words, don't put the hunks of metal under the incinerator because they don't burn. To solve this problem right now, the easiest thing to do is don't eat a lot of sugar and don't eat burned meat. When you eat those things, now we know they go in and they just stick right in the lysosome, and now your cells can't burn all the other bits of protein, so you end up getting, eventually, zombie cells because of that. So let's put less stuff in there that's harmful. So then there's accumulation of stuff outside the cells. This is another different set of problems, and there, it's amazing that sometimes fasting makes a really big difference for this.
Fasting does everything, huh?
As any animal ages, things that bioaccumulate get worse and worse. Otherwise, when you're 100 years old, you have 100 years of toxin buildup of these things that don't naturally leave the body. Take activated charcoal and do these things that allow the body to just naturally eliminate these things. Otherwise, they will go in and they'll be in your liver, they'll be in your brain, they'll be in your skeleton, and they'll be in your nervous system. One of the other seven pillars of aging is the telomere. If you have normal telomeres, you can copy a cell 37 times and then it won't do anything. And at that point, you get zombie cells. There's a Russian peptide, which is a small group of amino acids that's injectable. You inject it for 10 days once every 6 months, and it dramatically lengthens telomeres. So you can do that, and it costs $50. Epitalon, E-P-I-T-A-L-O-N. Number seven is loss of tissue. And if you are going to live for 100, 150 years, it's almost like having an investment in a bank account that compounds. So if you're saying, oh, I'm just gonna take aging the way it normally comes, you're gonna have really thin skin when you're old. There's things like red light therapy or just getting some sunshine. Not too much sunshine, but not no sunshine either. And so I feel that when we have a world full of people who have the wisdom of having experienced things, enough energy and enough desire to get back, it saves the rest of us a lot of time and energy to have that the village elder actually not have Alzheimer's disease and not be in a hospital. I feel safe now saying that we can turn the biological clock in our cells backwards because now we know why we age and what to do about it.